What's going on, rhythm game fans? Welcome to another episode of Rock Band History. This one could even be called Guitar Hero History, for all I care. So I want to talk about a time back in E3 2008, which is a really fun time to be a rhythm game fan because you had Guitar Hero World Tour being shown off, and you had Rock Band 2 with this premium drum kit being shown off. You had all these, you know, set list announcements. It was a really exciting time, much more exciting than last year, that's for sure. So let's talk about the war of words that happened between the Guitar Hero developers, Neversoft and Harmonix. So Guitar Hero sort of fired the first shots. They mocked the Rock Band cymbals. So at E3 2008, Harmonix announced they were coming out with a cymbal kit for the Rock Band 2 drum kit. Now, it was going to feature one, two, or three cymbals. I think you could buy them in different varieties. You could get a two-pack or a three-pack. I think you could even get a one-pack, possibly two, starting at $15. And, you know, Brian Bright, who was one of the main developers behind Guitar Hero World Tour at that time, had some fighting words for Rock Band. So basically, what he had to say is, I don't know how far ahead they planned that. We obviously revealed our drum kit much earlier than they did, referencing Harmonix's plan to release separate clip-on cymbals for Rock Band setups. I have a feeling there was an oh shit moment. They're cymbals. How can we put cymbals in our kit? That was the easiest way without having to rewire everything and re-engineer the entire circuit board. But John Drake fought back. He basically said, in Harmonix, we really are musicians first and game people second. My drum set has three cymbals on it. I don't know how many drum sets you've seen with two cymbals on them. I guess that's a question for other people. So those are kind of like the first friendly shots that were fired at E3. And then, as you know, we had the whole history between the different Guitar Hero and Rock Band games and, you know, different titles trying to poach certain bands and signing exclusive agreements. But I want to shed light on something that happened at E3. Let me know your thoughts. Do you guys remember this event? What were your memories of E3 2008? Let me know down below. And as always, guys, make sure you subscribe for the latest rhythm gaming news. Take care.